So Gabe, last year SC, now you're in the NBA with the hottest team in the world. How do you feel?
Feel pretty good. It doesn't get any better than this. You know, rookie with one of the best teams in the NBA. I got to play with three all-stars, Kevin Garnett, Paul, and Ray. I'm just enjoying myself right now.
How do they treat you? Because you're a rookie.
They don't treat me too bad. I've seen people that say they have it way worse than I do. They treat us like grown men, which we are. And they're just coming at us and just let us do our own thing. They don't really bother us too much. They might ask us to do things here and there, but there's nothing too major that we can't handle.
Now, Gabe, some people doubted you. They said, "What are you doing? You're not gonna do it." And look at you now. Like, how excited? Like, what would you say first of all to people and B? Do you believe it?
I've had doubters, throughout my whole career, and I just use that to motivate me and build, my self-esteem up, just to get better and prove people wrong. And when people say, "What am I doing? I wasn't gonna make it, this and that," I just use that to say, I'm gonna work that much harder to get where I want to be. And look at me now, I'm here.
Now you're from LA. There's tons of talent out of LA, but you're in Boston. They hate LA. How does that work?
It's not too bad. The Boston fans are very loyal, and they love their sports teams. They love the Celtics, and they show us a lot of love out there. From being from LA, wherever you're from, you're out there, you're playing for a team in Boston. They're gonna show you a lot of love, and they made me feel at home there. So I'm enjoying myself back in Boston. They make me feel right at home.
Now, what can you do about Boston fans? What I've noticed, no matter what city I'm in, there's always tons of Boston fans. Have you noticed that?
I noticed that every time we go on a road trip, and you see, it seems like sometimes we have more fans than the home team. There's a lot of supporters out there for the Boston, our Boston family, and they just come every day, all green, showing their support for us, and we really appreciate that. I picked 13 because I used to watch Steve Nash. When I was coming up, he was one of my favorite players, and that was one of the numbers that were available when I retired. So I decided to go with 13. Me being a point guard as well, and Steve Nash, being one of the top point guards, in the game, I decided to pick 13, because of that.
You were the leader in SC, the number one guy. Now you're in a different role. How do you adjust? I mean, from going from being like the main man to like off the bench supporter.
I noticed we have a lot of, like I said, we have three all stars and guys that's been here for a while, so they know what it's like, and just me, I'm just sitting back, learning, taking in what they show me, and using that to help me out. So when my time do come, I'll be able to come and respond right away. I don't have to work myself up and work myself way into the game. So I mean, it's tough, it's different. I've been playing and starting all my life, but now I got to start a new chapter. I'm here with a new team, new players, so I just got to get adjusted and work my way up to where I want to be.
Favorite moment with Ray, with Kevin, and with
Favorite moment. I think the favorite moment I've had with them is when we were in overseas in Rome. That was my first time, traveling overseas, and I had a chance to go on a tour with those guys to the Vatican and to the Colosseum. That meant a lot to me, and for me to start off my rookie year, first time at training camp with those guys, that was one of my best moments, as being an NBA player.
Did they pick on you for being a Trojan?
No, they didn't. Kevin came out of high school, and Paul kind of took me under his wing. They're both from LA, and Ray, he kind of guy, passed knowledge for it to us. So they kind of don't pick on me. We have bets here and there where we say, okay, whose team gonna win? The college team play each other, but it's all fun and games.
Last thing, there's an old saying: my haters are my motivators. Apply?
Yeah, that is true. That is true. There's a lot of haters. You either let them bring you down or help you build yourself up. And I use them to help me build myself up to get that for motivation to get where I want to be and be successful.
From the Staples Center in downtown Los Angeles, I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.